Yeah, good morning students. How are you today? Yeah, students, now we are going to do our next topic, that is our next chapter, that is journal entry, that is chapter 9 of accountancy. Journal right? So journal is basically books of original entry in which transaction is recorded firstly. All transactions are recorded firstly in the journal book, but this is not in all types of business. Only the business which are having limited transactions, they will maintain journal books. And if a business has so much transaction, then they have to maintain sub journal books, that are some subsidiary books, cash book, purchase book, sale book, purchase return, sale return book, right? And bill receivable book, bills payable book, and journal proper. So while recording journal entry, we have to follow some rules while making journal entry. So while making journal entry, first of all, we have to check whether which two account are going to be impact. So first of all, we will identify by one transaction how many accounts are impacted. There may be two or more than two accounts may be impacted by one transaction. So we have to record all the transaction in journal. From the journal, all transactions are posted to the ledger, right? And ledger is a book in which every account is separate maintained for recording transaction, right? So while doing journal, we have to use some rules. Like, I'm talking about goods. What do you understand by goods? Goods means anything in which a businessman deals. For example, a cloth merchant, then cloth will be goods for him. If he purchases the goods, then the purchase account will be used for purchasing goods. But if he purchases some another property, like he purchased furniture, then it will be not recorded in purchase account. So purchase account will be treated only for the purchase of goods. Whenever a business purchases goods, the purchase account is used for that, not the goods account. Like this, whenever a businessman sells goods, only the sale account is to be used, not the goods account. So purchase account is always debited, sale account is always credited. The reason behind is nominal account rule. Nominal account rule, we have already studied that in the class, that all expenses and losses are debit, all incomes and gains are credit. So purchase are losses or expenses, sales are income. So purchase will account debit and sale account will be credit, right? And in the third rule, whenever we made the journal entry, for example, it is given purchase goods, only it is given purchase goods, it is given only, then it will be treated as cash purchase, right? And fourth one, whenever it is given purchase goods for 2000 from Ravi for cash, it is also cash transaction, right? And the next one is, whenever we Fifth rule, whenever we purchase goods, Som, Ravi, amount rupee 20,000, then it will be treated as a credit transaction. This means when only personal account is given, then only it will be treated as a credit transaction, right? So next is for expense. Regarding expense, there is a rule. Like example, I am taking rent paid, it is given. This means rent is an expense, it will be debit to always cash account, will be credit. Why? Because always expenses are debited, and in case of expenses we should not take it for that it is paid to anyone. Rent paid to Ram, rent paid to landlord, it may be given, but you have to take it as an expense, that rent account debit. Whether it is paid to anyone, it does not impact the business. It only impacts the second account, that is cash account. The only cash account will be credited. So these are the some rules. And one more rule is, that is about personal account. When preparing journal entry, personal account does not need to be followed by account or account word. They are not needed to be right. Only we can say Ram. There is no need to write after that account. Right? That is the rule of personal account. And after that, we will do rules of journal entry. That is three golden rules which we will follow in preparing journal entry. Right? That three golden rules are rules of double entry system. First is real account rule. Real account rule is debit what comes in credit what goes out. Real account includes all properties, all assets, right? And whenever an asset comes in, it will be debited, and an asset goes out from the business, it will be credited, right? So these rule will be followed. And for example, a businessman purchased furniture for cash. In that case, furniture is coming inside furniture account debit. Furniture is an asset, and second account, cash is going out from the business to cash account, will be credit, right? Amount may be 5,000, 50,000, it will be debited as well as credit. So this is the rule of real account. After that, we are going to do next rule, that is rule of personal account. Personal account means the account of X, Y, Ram, company, kisi ka bhi account ho, that is personal account. And the rule is debit the receiver credit the giver. This means we have to debit that person to whom we are giving money, or credit the person from whom we are receiving the money. right? For example, I have received money from Shyam, right? Received money from Shyam. Then cash is coming inside. Cash account will be debit to Shyam is the giver because he is giving money to us. Then Shyam account will be credited amount 2000 IMD. Right? So in front of personal account there is no need to write any account word. So cash account debit to Shyam account if there is a giver. If we are giving money to anyone like XYZ company is our creditor, we are paying money to them. Then in case XYZ company debit to cash account. Right? So this means XYZ company will be the receiver. In that case, debit the receiver. So and next is cash is going out from the business, that will be credited. So this is the rule of personal account. And third rule is rule of nominal account. In case of nominal account, we have to follow the rule, debit all expenses and losses, credit all income and gains. Right? So in this case, you have to, for example, I am taking that rent paid 7000, then rent account will be debit as it is an expense of the business. Second account is impacted by it, that is cash account. Cash account will be credit as cash is going out from the business. In case of cash account, simply you may learn that if cash is coming inside the business, cash will be debited, and if cash is going out from the business, cash account will be credited. Right? So this is the entry. And regarding income, like received commission, it is given. Cash account debit, cash is coming inside to commission account. Right? So these are the basic rule for preparing journal entry. After preparing the learning the rule of journal entry, we will do the format of journal entry. Right? What is the format of journal entry? It has 5 columns. First of all, you have to write the name, books of the firm. For example, books of CRM and Sons. It is given. Right? And first column is of date. Second column is of particulars. And next column is of ledger folio. Next is debit amount and credit amount. So these are the 5 columns of preparing journal entry that you have to prepare. Right? And date, it will be given in the question, accordingly you have to write. In column of particulars, you have to maintain the debit or credit accounts. And ledger folio, actually it is the page number of the ledger on which these journal will be posted, and that you will see when you will prepare the ledger. And these are the column debit and the credit where we will write the amount. So, right?